Now we're going to take a look at Ellen, who is our hero character, and how she's put together. And then we'll also look at putting in the first peril in our game level. So if I go to the hierarchy and click on Ellen, this is Ellen in the scene. And as you see here, she's got a lot of components that make her up. She's already set up and good to go. So you don't really need to change anything unless you want to start customizing, in which case you can look into the component reference and see what all the settings mean. One thing I'm going to point out here is that she already has a damageable component. And a damageable component means that she can receive damage from any other game object that has a damager. So this will be sort of one of the key aspects to causing her harm. Not that we'd want to, but that's part of the game. So let's look at adding in a little bit of peril. So I'm going to just go to the project window. I'm going to close up this art folder so it's not too long here, and I'm going to open up the prefabs folder, and I'm going to go into the environment folder. And in the environment folder, we've got two things that sort of environmental and cause her harm. We have some acid and some spikes. So I can click and drag some spikes into here, and these are already set up to cause her damage. If we look at the spikes, there is the damager component in the inspector there. So that will cause her damage. I'd like to fill this gap here, and I'm going to do that by adding in some acid. This acid is already set up again just to cause her damage. If I scroll down in the inspector, we have the damager here as well. So one thing that I want to do with this water is take a look at the water area component in the inspector. And here I can actually change the size. So it's a little bit too small and it doesn't quite fit. It's a bit awkward. So I'm just going to place it around about the middle there. And in the size option in the water area script, I'm going to click and drag on where it says X and just resize this a little bit. And then I'm going to click and drag on Y. And I think that might be a bit good. I'm going to just lower this. And if I press play, I should be able to walk into the spikes and into the acid and cause her some damage. So pressing play. If I walk into the spikes, she already receives damage, and you can see that we have a UI element here that sort of signifies her health, and that's already set up and ready to go. If I go in there, everything is set up and ready to go. So we need to put a gameplay element to get over this. So as we saw in the example scene, we're going to include a moving platform.